Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Tuesday Morning. My name is Stephen Whiteside from theuptrend.com with today's look at U.S. stock market trends. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are above fair value. Dow futures currently up over 300 points. They've been up all night, up all morning, so it certainly looks like we're going to see some buying at the open on Tuesday morning. Let's start off looking at the VIX. The VIX is still on a daily sell signal. That's supportive for higher stock prices. Things would change on Tuesday with a close above 53.77. Not expecting that to happen. There's the Spider ETF, still on a buy signal, of course, and a small pullback yesterday. The lower channel line is currently at 255.82. You can expect that to move higher today. Coming up to the 50-day moving average, if we can get over that, you can see the 100 and 200-day just above. There's the cues for the NASDAQ 100. They were actually higher yesterday. And so the lower channel line is currently at 189.10. That's going to move higher on Tuesday. And we're about to break out above all the moving averages. So that's very bullish. Of course, it's the technology stocks that fell the least and have come back the fastest. And here we are trying to break out above $200. You can see we've been stuck there for the past 4 days. And it looks like we're going to be able to break out above the recent highs on Tuesday. 212.50 is our next mathematical target. You'd want to take money off the table up at that level. Looking at some of the technology stocks that are moving the market higher, starting off with Facebook, we're on a buy signal right now, certainly not leading the market higher. That would be left up to stocks like Amazon and Netflix that it had incredibly nice days on Monday. Then Google, a stock I own, not going anywhere quickly at the moment. Let's move on to my five stocks. I'm currently long Apple Computer. Next target to the upside is 281.25. Got orders in to get filled up at that level. Then looking at the CME Group. The CME Group is currently stuck at 187.50. And if you look back on the left there, you'll see the bottom of an open gap right there. And that's where we're having trouble getting up and over. If we can get up and over Friday's high on Tuesday, then $200 comes into play and we've got an order in up at that level. Next up, looking at Google, $1,250 is our next target to the upside. We have orders in to get filled up there. Next up, we're looking at Goldman Sachs. And Goldman Sachs, our next mathematical target was 187.50. But if you look over here, there's an open gap that still has not been filled. So while the mathematical target was 187.50, we got as high as 187.33. We actually put an order in over here at the 185.40 level. That order got filled. We still have orders in at 187.50. We'll sell a few shares off at that level if we can get up there. And then, of course, if we break out above that, 203.13 is the next target to the upside. And, of course, we'll take a look at that when we break through the 187.50 level. Last up for my five stocks, Visa still on a buy signal here. Not moving too fast, too quickly. We hit the 175 level. If we can take out last week's high, then 187.50 comes into play. Let's finish off looking at commodities. And the only thing really moving right now is the GLD or gold, and made a new high for this move. 165.63 is the next target to the upside. Palladium not moving anywhere quickly, still in the channel. Silver not moving anywhere quickly, still on a buy signal. 1563 is the next target to the upside, but I would imagine that the bottom of this open gap is going to act as resistance on the way up. And then looking at energy, nothing going on with crude oil. Crude oil closed yesterday at $4.93. We need to close below 482 on Tuesday to give us a sell signal. There's gasoline still at the upper channel line, no change there. And natural gas is still on a buy signal, but pulling back. And you can see the pattern is still in play. We recently made a lower low, and it looks like we're making a lower high. So this pattern that has been going on for a long time has not changed. So we're still looking for a breakout above these highs over here to tell us that something new is going on for natural gas. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation, looking for higher prices on Tuesday. If you've made it this far and you haven't got sick and your family hasn't got sick, congratulations, but there's no reason to give up at this point. You need to continue to do what you're doing. You need to wash your hands constantly. You need to stay away from other people, stay indoors as much as possible. And if you have to go out, wear a mask. If you have to go out to go shopping, you know, it should be just one of you. You don't have to take the whole family shopping. Just one at a time will probably be the safest thing to do. So congratulations for not getting sick. Congratulations for making it this far. We still have a lot of work to do before this is over, but you can do it. Don't give up. Have a great day, folks. And the next time you'll hear my voice is on Wednesday morning. And at that time, we'll take a closer look at the Canadian stock market.